LCN presents Cal State Fullerton Titan Baseball.
It's a cool, clear Southern California Friday evening at Cal State Fullerton's Titan Field. I'm Brent Weber with Paul Westfall. It is a battle for the Big West Conference lead and a battle between two of California, the West Coast, and frankly the nation's premier college baseball programs. Good evening and welcome to Cal State Fullerton's Goodwin Field, where tonight the nation's 19th ranked Titans entertain the Aztecs of San Diego State in a midweek non-conference game. I'm Brent Weber with Paul Westfall. Now, these two teams recently renewed a rivalry. Oh, good evening. I'm Brent Weber alongside Paul Westfall. Tonight, the nation's 21st ranked Cal State Fullerton Titans entertain the UC Santa Barbara Gauchos in Big West Conference Baseball on the Orange County News Channel. The Titans lead the Big West Conference now by two games after winning game one of this series, Paul Westfall, and they, of course, improved their record to 26-14, 14-5 in the Big West Conference. And for them, important to get a Friday night victory, but most importantly, with Long Beach State idle, they get a little bit of room to breathe in the Big West.
2-2 pitch. Swung on, hit sharply through the hole, right side base hit. One runner will score. McConney, he'll score, and the Titans have rallied for four in the ninth to down the Trojans at Goodwin Field.
Now see what you could have been doing all along if they weren't swinging at that first pitch. AJ's happy about it, don't get me wrong. They all pitch, off-speed, called strike three. Adam Johnson, fitting for this Friday night at Goodwin Field, punches out the final batter, Don Price, one of the most prolific power hitters in Big West Conference history, on a called third strike. His ninth of the game, the Titans blank the Wolfpack, the first time in 101 games.
I believe he was drafted by the Marlins in the expansion draft.
Smith. There's a pickoff move that they hadn't seen, and he caught Dennis Gomez leaning to the outhouse.
729 on a chilly night at Goodwin Field here at Cal State Fullerton, and many more at home watching. We appreciate that. Fastball bounced right side. Bacani has one play. No, he goes to second. One on to first. Double play. A dazzling 4-6-3 unexpected twin killing. The Titans have some surprises for you tonight. A 10-6 win over a very good University of Tennessee team. What a way to start the baseball bash, Paul Westfall. 1-2, off-speed, swung on, hit high and deep to center. Duffy on his horse. Will he get to it? He makes a diving try. No, he doesn't. Martinez still hadn't stopped moving full speed. He's got a triple. He could have stood up there. And the Titans have tied it at two on Mike Martinez's first extra base hit of the year 2001.
To go.
Hit a ton to right. You can knock the pollen off of the flowers in the arboretum because Aaron Rifkin has just dusted the Rose Garden.
At some point in here, he's going to be drinking a beer and playing softball before this day's out, from the looks of that.
I notice he didn't begin the game with almost all of those buttons unbuttoned, but he's gotten to where they're almost all undone.
Swung on, hit high to left field. Christensen got there in a hurry and has plenty of time to wait on it and makes the catch for out number one. I am having a good time at Bertolino's expense. But, you know, if you let the fourth button come open, you're pretty much fair game. But I'm thinking one more button there, he's getting it, because one more button, he was going to be dancing in an adult club, and his mother would not be happy about it. And a payoff pitch coming with the bases loaded and nobody out for Murph Norris against Qualls the ace. Bounces it up the middle. Will they get through? Yes. One run will score. Rifkin comes around. He'll score. And the Titans have a 3-0 lead. Well, it looks like a line drive in the box score. The Titans are going to have to play catch-up if they want to end this day on top of the Big West standings. Here's Chuck Lopez.
Oh,
Lopez is 1-for-3. And he hits a shot down the line and right, and it is way out of here. Lopez's 6th home run of the season. Give him 2 more runs batted in. He now has a team-leading 32. And the Dirtbags have blown this thing wide open. That's the next relief pitcher for the Aztecs coming. Oh, no, I'm sorry. They might need to call for some outside help the way the Titans have exploded here. Runner going. They've got the double steal on, the delay to try to draw a play at the plate. Now they got the runner caught off third. Beck and the throw into left field, and that's what it's supposed to do. Create havoc on the base pass. Here comes Guzman. He's got to get down, and he's in there. So the Titans take some chances, try to stick a dagger into the hearts of the Aztecs, and they score 2 as San Diego State bites into the double steal. One who will not be coming in 2 years, though, stolen away from him by the alma mater, Coach Dietz, probably the easiest recruiting he ever had to do to get Tony Gwynn Jr. Oh, Weller hits a ton out of this one, and it's out of here. Move the bus, Betty. It's hitting the roof. Josh Weller sends a shot, his first home run as a Cal State Fullerton Titan.
Oh.
You can log on to broadcast.com, and if you're a real junkie, you can hear archived transmissions of the game broadcasts from previous games. One ball, no strike pitch. Off the fist should be 2. Martinez to Bacani, to Rifkin, who finishes the job in dramatic fashion, and serving as the fence post, a little game of leapfrog, but regardless, the Titans get a twin killing to get out of it here in the 8th. Beck would like to get something up. I'm sure McCulloch is thinking strikeout in this situation. Aaron Rifkin is on deck, and Brett Kay in the hole. Titans looking to break out of it here. All they need is 1. That one's away, 1-2. He tried to get Beck to chase something. Heated it up on the outside corner. There's the man who started it all. David Bacani at third base. Has had a dazzling game defensively. And his speed could, who knows, be the difference when it's all said and done. Titans win it on a base hit through the drawn-in infield. Bacani plates the game-winning run, and Chris Beck comes up with the game-winning hit. For the 2nd Friday night in a row, we've got some drama for you here live on OCN. Chris Beck did his job. The infield was in, he hit it sharply, and the Hustlin' Rebels had no prayer of making it happen. 2 runs, 8 hits, no errors. 1 run, 7 hits, no errors for the Hustlin' Rebels, and let's watch it again. The bases were juiced, and Beck put the bat on it.
Went the other way with the pitch, gets the line drive just past the outstretched glove of Shitanishi, and Bacani steps on the plate with the game-winning run.
Alrighty, when we come back from a break, our player of the game and head coach George Horton all still ahead. You're watching Titan Baseball.